Okay, I want to talk specifically about the theming in MarkEdit. So I've mentioned before that MarkEdit has a variety of theming options, some new accessibility options. They're found inside the options menu. So there are three potential places where you would set fonts in the MarkEditor. These are fonts specifically to the MarkEditor themselves. Under language, this is the font and font size for the application and the application windows. For theming, so for related to the colors scheme, generally within the application, those are found under the ease of use. So the normal default option is what's set by default. Let's say we want to use a different theme. So there are three by default. One is the dark high contrast, which turns everything black and white. One is the dark gray theme, which takes a little bit of the dark off. And then one is very stark. It's a white theme where all of the controls are turned white. However, those are three fairly generic theming elements. Maybe you want to create your own. So within MarkEdit, the themes can control font colors, window colors, and a few other things. So this is the theme builder. It shows you what the theme is. It loads into the default theme. So this will be my custom theme. Description. This is just an XML file. So you can see the values you can set using the theme builder. You've got the global font color, which is the font color of the window, the background color, which is the background color of the window, a group box background. These are grouping elements that I use in MarkEdit to designate usually options or pieces of functionality. You can change those, otherwise they'll be paired with the background. And then the MarkEditor, this is a hosted version of the MarkEditor control. You can set the font and background color of that piece of the application separately. So let's go ahead and try this out. So we can set the global font color. So in this case, it's all black. Let's say we wanted to create a theme that mirrored the colors of Australia. So colors of Australia are green and yellow. So I am going to set my font to be a nice yellow and quite possibly something in a little bit of a darker yellow so it shows up a little bit. I'm going to set the background as a green. We'll try this one, but I think it's going to be way too light. And then if we wanted, we could decide to do something with the background boxes, and I do. So I'm going to use a different off-green, so slightly easier shade. And then we can leave these boxes as black and white. So we can preview that. And so you can see the theme that would be saved is applied. So we can look at this and see, is this to our liking? It's not. The background color is a wee bit too light for me. So I'm going to go ahead and darken it a bit. A little bit of a darker green, which means that the background box, I'm going to go ahead and give it the lighter green and try that. So there we go. So here we have a theme that gives me a kind of a gold font, a dark green background, and a lighter green in the group box. I left my text box, my MarkEditor box, black and white. I can go ahead and save that. Go to my custom themes and select my custom theme. Hit OK. And now it loads up into my theme, and you can see the box here, which gives me that little off-green color. I can see that in my other places, a little off-green color. Otherwise, the rest of the application uses the font colors that have been defined. Those also replicate into the menu. So this gives us a chance to expand a little bit on the application so that you can make it look and work a little bit more to your liking. And so that's it. If you want to share a theme, you can go to Help and Application Shortcuts and Theme Path, and this will open up the themes directory and you can find them. They're just XML files. If you want to delete a theme, the easiest way to do it is to go back to ease of use, select custom themes, pick the theme that you want to delete, and delete the selected one, and it gets dropped out of the list. And that's it. If you have any questions,